Again, your comments 253131. Now, there's nothing like sporting a sun-kissed tan. It makes you feel and look great. However, for some, it's just not that easy to get right. And some people just don't get that sometimes less is more. And don't think you lads are getting off scot-free. You're also as guilty as a bejesus when it comes to this. I mean, who is letting them out of the house looking like this? And we do have a bit of an agenda when it comes to talking about tan, because Jen, you've launched your own tan, jelly tan, which is lovely, but it's for obvious reasons. Why did you think there's so many hundreds of tans on the market now? What makes you want so brilliant?
Well, it kind of came across about in a different way. I own a dance studio, it's a performing arts college, and all the kids, we've got like champions there now. Whenever they compete, they've got to have a tan, because you know, as lazy as yourself, whenever you have a tan, you feel better, your body looks better, defines the muscles and stuff. So they all have to have a tan. And they were all going into school the next day, and they were getting dragged into the headmaster's office. Why have you got this tan on? So they were like, we can't have a tan. And I was like, you've got to have a tan. So I basically thought, we need a tan that's as dark, that looks as good, but washes off. So I developed it for the dancers in the school initially. And then everyone was going, oh my God, the colour's so fabulous. Can you make it a permanent one, a semi-permanent one? So we were like, we went into discussions, kind of developed it, and we've got the range now, yeah. So it's kind of
when it stays on, go back to the original one first. Now. So you rub it on, and if it rains on you, will it come off?
No,
or do you have to
give it
a good scrub?
Yeah, because dancers sweat.
Yeah.
You know, so it's got to be really dark. It's got to stay on through sweat and through the whole day of dance, but then it washes off.
Yeah. Did you ever do dancing?
No, and I don't. No offense or anything, but I don't think I'm going to be putting my kid through dancing, because yeah. I don't like the fact, I don't understand why they have to wear makeup and why they do have to wear the tan, and that's one of the reasons why I'm not going to throw her
they
in.
Do it for Irish dancing as well.
Yeah, I don't, and they have the ringlets.
Yeah, they didn't when I was young.
Yeah.
No, you had to have your hair in ringlets, or you have to have it pinned back with your uniform, whatever dance school you were with, but you didn't have to wear tans. Yeah. You didn't
but
have
it's
wear
everywhere
makeup.
Now. I mean, I know one of the girls who runs an Irish dancing school that used to work here, and she said it actually brings them at a huge disadvantage if they don't have the tan, if they don't have the hair done. Is it more almost as much about the look now when you're competing at a dance competition than the actual dance?
Unfortunately, yeah, it is. And because when you're putting your kids up there, adjudicators will mark them down if they haven't got that right look.
Yeah. And what, like, are they all up for it? Do you find sometimes that they're enjoying it, or do you ever see the kind of pushy side of it?
The mums can be pushy, yeah, which obviously I've had a TV show about that. But the kids, I'm not talking about kids who are going for enjoyment. Like,
yeah.
We've got my Sunday Academy where they go and have fun, and they do good toes, naughty toes. But these kids are like Premiership footballers. They are world champions. I've just had two world champion title holders. So they are doing it at a professional level. Now, when they're doing it at a professional level, it's a completely different kettle of fish. They do need to look a certain way. They do need to have the tan, because the people who they're going up against have got that. So it's a completely, I mean, I know what you're saying about your little girl. My little boys won't do it. They just don't want to do it. But, you know, some kids do want to do it.
Some kids enjoy the whole thing of it. Would you have been a dancer?
My mother used to teach me when I was young to do all the traditional dances, like waltzes and all the old hat stuff, quick steps and foxtrots. And I studied piano for many, many years, so I'd have a bit of rhythm, but I wouldn't be very good.